Hi everyone, my name is Dr. Mansi Sanghvi and I am a dermatologist and a trichologist practicing in Mumbai. My clinic's name is Skin 360 Skin and Hair Clinic and we are located at Powai in the central Mumbai area. Today I'll be talking to you about the commonest pigmentation that we find in Indian population. It's called melasma and I think that term we all are aware of. It typically is known as hormonal pigmentation. Of all the patients that I see who present with melasma, almost 70 to 75% of them are women. Although I do see melasma happening in men nowadays, the commonest cause of melasma is hormonal conditions or imbalance, typically seen in women after pregnancy or after abortion. It can also be seen after taking post-coital pills, which is called emergency contraceptive pills. It can also occur after or during the menopausal phase. So typical age that I see my patients presenting with is in mid-20s to mid-50s. In addition to the hormonal factors, another very common factor is sun exposure, which adds on to the severity of melasma. The melasma pigmentation do become darker with sun exposure sometimes. Many other things can aggravate the appearance of the pigmentation. Some factors like vigorous and frequent scrubbing with coarse particles like sugar or scrub granules can also add on to the pigmentation because Indian skin cannot take any kind of a little torture on it. So the friction can lead to more pigmentation. So one should avoid scrubbing the skin frequently when they have melasma-like condition. Many people try home remedies for melasma, including scrubbing or applying something which is available in the kitchen or going to the pharmacist to pick up over-the-counter medicine. Let me tell you one thing, over-the-counter medicines and home remedies sometimes can give you irritable skin, which itself can later on be sunburned and can give you rebound pigmentation. So try to avoid doing home remedies and going to pharmacist to figure out what to do for your melasma. You can always pick up a nearby dermatologist, go see the reviews, understand what your doctor is telling you and do the treatments accordingly. So what are the treatment options we have for melasma and what all can be done for it? So first question is, can it be cured? Let me tell you one thing, melasma cannot be cured, but it can be controlled very well. We can probably do certain treatments for you or prescribe you certain creams which are efficient in controlling the pigmentation, reducing it even by 50 to 80% depending upon how deep the pigmentation is, and it can be maintained pretty well for a long time. Once the pigmentation has gone by 50 to 60%, it is light enough to be covered by little makeup product that we use in our day-to-day life. Something that can prevent melasma from coming back, and it is very important, is sunscreen. What come May, whatever season of the year it is, whatever month it is, or whether it is a cloudy atmosphere or a sunny exterior, you need to put a sunscreen, especially between 8 a.m. until 6:30 in the evening. You need to pick up a sunblock which is at least SPF 40 or above for Indian skin type. And it is important to put a sunscreen at least 20 minutes before stepping out and make sure that you are reapplying it every 3 to 4 hourly for efficient protection towards sun. Nowadays, most of us work indoors, especially in a cabin which is well lit and in front of the PC or laptop all the time. Those screen also emits some amount of infrared radiation and it is important to use a sunblock during that time as well. So sunblocks are now available for giving protection to your skin not only from ultraviolet rays but also from infrared rays. So pick up a sunblock accordingly, ask your doctor, they can help you very well with the right product that suits your skin type and also gives you optimum sun protection. Second thing that you can use to nourish your skin so that the skin barrier function is restored very well and skin can be exfoliated on timely interval is moisturizer. It's very important to moisturize your skin so that you can restore the skin barrier which can protect you better from the harmful effect of ultraviolet radiation. Third thing, your doctor may prescribe you certain creams which can really help to reduce the pigmentation of your melasma. Melasma can be can present any part of your face, but typically it starts on the cheek, then forehead, nose, upper lip and chin also. Depending upon the location, we can pick up the right treatment for you, which can help you look better in terms of making the pigmentation look lighter. So the treatment that we can do for your melasma would range from not only just simple peels that doctor does in their office, but also some special lasers which help to lighten the pigmentation much faster. But it is very important to go to the right person, a right expert and a right dermatologist who can help you figure out what suits you better for your kind of skin and for the pigmentation that you have. Certain lasers work very well for melasma, but we need to choose the strength and the fluence, the dose of the laser in an optimum way so that we are treating it, we are making it lighter, but we are not damaging it. In certain cases, if the laser is handled by a non-experienced person, then it can lead to rebound pigmentation as well. So be careful while choosing your doctor and the right center to go and do your treatment. So I have tried to share as much of information as I could over here for you all. If you have any further questions regarding pigmentation or melasma or any other skin condition or the hair condition that you are dealing with, you can book an appointment with us using Lybrate.com. Thank you very much.